When I was in the plane and the door was closed, I said, thanks God.
Okay.
Because that's when I thought I was very safe.
Der findes næppe noget farligere job, som en journalist kan påtage sig. Rejs til Somalia, find de lokale pirater og forsøg så at få et interview med de danske gidsler, der sidder fanget på anden måned.
It's nice to have you back.
Thank you.
And safe back.
Men netop det er lykkedes for Ekstrabladets journalist her, der godt vidste, at hans opgave var meget farlig.
Before I left the hotel, you know, I was standing three times thinking, are you going or you stay? I even knew it was foolish to go such risk.
Yeah.
But I asked myself, if you don't do this now, who will do it?
Vejen frem til piraterne gik gennem flere svært befæstede checkpoints, og der var timevis af kørsel på svært fremkommelige veje. Den sidste del af rejsen skete i denne motoriserede jolle, og fremme ved de danske gidsler fik journalisten lov til at fotografere deres løsbåd, men ikke det fragtskib, som gidslerne bliver holdt fanget på.
They were threatening me not to take photos of the ship.
Yeah.
They were saying to me, if you take the photos of the ship, we'll kill you. Everyone was like this.
Yeah.
Without motion, without talking.
Yeah.
But one of the two guys who are with the family also put his head in his knees and was sitting like this.
Yeah.
All the time he was there. And the other one was just pushing his hand in the head and he was just doing something that he's dealing with headache.
Piraterne havde lovet et interview til Ekstrabladet, men det blev ikke til noget. Alligevel tror vores journalist, at danskerne gerne ville have talt.
So you think that Jan was actually happy to see you?
Yeah. I think Jan was ready to talk.
Søndag kan du i Ekstrabladet læse hele den utrolige fortælling om, hvordan man slipper levende fra at rapportere på klodens farligste sted for journalister.